all the blessings, you know. And I said, I'm going to stay encouraged. I'm going to stay encouraged. I'm not going to let no, you know, no words, no nothing affect the way my heart feels, you know. And I just want to thank God this morning. I want to give Him glory this morning. Thank the Lord, because I'm living. I'm able to move my limbs, Lord. And I thank Him this morning. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
So I say, thank God that I can come and pray every morning.
Yeah, Lord Jesus.
You know, sometimes we don't know how God working in our ways, but you know, He's
right.
Working in our ways for the best.
Yeah.
So, you know, I ask myself, is it okay for, you know, hey, when 6:45, you know, come along, you wake the rail up, you know, that's no problem. So, you know, I thank God for that. But yesterday,
yeah, you know, thank you, Lord.
I struggled trying to get here yesterday, but I had a bad battery in my truck, and the devil tried to stop me. He stopped me for one day, but you know, I can't get to the you know, I'm a very busy person.
Yeah.
And Sister Smith and Brother Smith, if y'all ever need some help, I'm a person getting on to do it all. So, you know, you don't have to worry about taking your money.
Yes.
You know, I can do the plumbing, the gas. I mean, you name it, I can do it.
You know, the Lord, He puts people in your
midst
for reasons.
Yes.
He does. It always happens.
Yes, so, you know, I mean, if y'all have needs, you know,
right.
He can always call me.
Well, thank you.
But at the same time, I worked very late last night. And on top of that, my last job, I got cussed out. But I had to hold my tongue. I said, Lord, just hold my tongue. You're too
wonderful.
Everything in the world trying to please this woman, I couldn't please her. So I finished her job. I got home around about 9 o'clock last night. And I said, Lord, you got to get me up in the morning. But I got up at 3 o'clock and started getting ready. I was at this church at about 10 minutes to find where the one here. So I went down the street to look at another house I was supposed to do. But by the time we came in, everybody was here. But I was here 10 minutes to five. And I called Pastor Hill. I said, we have a prayer this morning. But he announced the phone. So I just thank God that he does great things for me. You know, He put a person in my life so I can come to church. I'm coming for him.
That's right.
And at the same time, Pastor Hill, you know, though he's there, I'm here at 5 o'clock until the time you say, hey, cut it off.
Yes, Lord Jesus. That's beautiful.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
I
get
mine in before I have to leave.
Thank you, Lord.
All this week has been good.
Yes.
I've been saying that a long time. Every time we have morning prayer, so I don't get up and go to prayer. It seemed like something that didn't let me do it. But this week, I tell you what, I got up at 4 o'clock, and like the Lord just waking me right up at 4 o'clock.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
So I had to get here at 5.
Yeah.
And all this, like I said, at work is very stressful, but this week has been a good week. I don't know, it's just been a good week. And last night it was good. It was just a few of us out here, but honey, we prayed. I believe my aches and pains is, you know how you do sometimes when you kind of get up in age. But this week I haven't had any. Thank the Lord.
All right, I got mine. 5 weeks ago, some of you might already know, my car was stolen.
Yeah.
And so that always creates a problem and an issue. It always happens at an inopportune time. And so for the last 2 weeks, you know, it's been a little struggle getting around. But I've always had transportation ability to get around. Brother Allen's offered me rides. Brother Curtis has given me rides. Al has given me rides. To get here, getting to work hasn't been an issue.
Thank the Lord.
It's been real easy.
Thank the Lord.
And a couple of days ago, I went to look at a vehicle, and me and Brother Al, we prayed about it, and before I even went in there, and as it turned out, everything worked out just right.
Yes.
Not so much as getting a vehicle, but it's making sure I get the right one.
That's right.
That fits my needs.
That's right.
And when it comes to, you know, paying money, I make sure it fits within my
yes.
range. So everything worked out just great. And this evening, I should be picking it up. Like Sister Gaynell said, people are put in your path to help you. Even in some of the small ways, even some of my coworkers offer me rides to work, that sort of thing. So people come at you, and they just all mean good. And I just appreciate the fact that God does that for us.
Yeah.
Even when we think that it's a hardship, it's not. People are doing things because they want to help you, and sometimes we have to just allow them to do that.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
Without any fear, without any paybacks or anything.
Yes, that's right.
Just have
that's
to right. allow God to work and let them do what they would like to do for you.
Yes.
And I always believe that there will come a time as well. And I'm like brother Curtis. If anybody ever needs me, and if there's anything I can do to help you, I'll definitely do it.
Yes, man.
Yes. That's just another way of paying back what you've been given, what you've been blessed with.
Yes. Oh, Smith, you're going to be leaving in a minute, but we've got to get you back. Oh, Bob.
Don't worry. Amen.
Yes, that was
a
beautiful.
And I have peace, thank God.
That's good. Home invasions,
you know, we're just saying a little bit of everything. This is the season, the holiday time.
Yes.
It's just funny to me how we get close to Christmas, which is a crisis.
Yeah.
And everybody acts a fool.
Yes.
It just behooves me why that happens. You know, sometimes. But you know, we got to pray. Not just for everyone that's here this morning.
Yeah.
Everyone that's out there. Yeah. The word of prayer will go a whole long way. You know, so we just got to ask the Lord to just keep his loving arms of protection on all of us.
Yeah.
And he will do it. He will
play
the church.
Amen.
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 Yeah.
Yeah.
That's one of every words.
I can say I appreciate all the saints here for us. And all of you have been a really good source of encouragement and support to me. I just enjoy all the testimonies. And I was just thinking about a recent blessing that I received. And it was, for me, Tuesday night from the women's meeting. We had such a beautiful women's meeting.
Yeah.
And those that were there, and while I taught the lesson, but everybody fed into, I pulled from everybody else.
Yes.
And it was really, really a blessing. And it occurred to me when Brother Al was talking, Sister Yasmin, and it's no secret because she said it before the church, that some challenges you all had, but she didn't go into detail.
No.
But she said that what really has helped her was Pastor and us talking with her. And the women's group, and the thing she said, just learning, that has really, really helped her. And so, you know, what I'm gleaning from is that we are helping one another.
Yes.
No man is an idol. We don't stand alone.
Yeah.
We're here to support each other. And what if Sister Danielle had not testified this morning? Then she realized there are two brothers here.
Yes.
That can help. Yes. Three men. So we're helping one another. And even though our women's group is kind of small, we'd like to expand it more and have more women coming. I believe the ones that are coming is really, there's a growth that's taking place.
Yes, it is.
Am I right, Sister
Sharon?
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. The growth that's taking place that we, you know, as I said, I feed off of you too. And that's what we're about. You know, when we come together corporately, we should feed off of each other.
That's
I
right.
feed off of everybody. I listen, Brother Curtis's testimony, every Brother Al's, and Sister Gaynell, Brother Rod, everybody,
yes.
Sister Shirley.
Yes.
This has just really been a blessing this morning.
Yes.
You know, you listen and you glean, and you just kind of put it all together, and you just see how God blesses each one of us in his own way according to what our needs are, you know. And he would, and Sister Judy had a beautiful testimony, beautiful one. And I just don't understand how she can work so hard and come in here with a hand. It's like she got all this energy.
Everybody have a blessed day.
Yes.
Thank you.
Amen. So we just wanted to encourage you. Amen. This is a season
Jesus is about to come. Amen. We're going to get back on that teaching soon. So your people are going to be saved. Somebody's going to have to what? Amen. Reach them. Somebody's going to have to share with them.
Yes.
Get them to church. Tell them that they need to come and, you know, and receive what we're receiving.
Yes.
Amen. So we just want to, I'm going to be making calls this week. And, you know, we can do a lot more. You know, people around us, we know who ain't doing. We know who ain't coming. Amen. If the women have to organize and start going into homes and stir these folks up. I mean, our members or whatever, amen, I think that some members would be blessed if two or three sisters would go in and just pray there. Amen. Praise God. Same with men. Some of these spouses, amen, that's not coming. Amen. We just need to pray, amen, and not just pray, but put some legs on our prayers.
Yes. Hallelujah.
And I want somebody to read that prayer, a prayer for me. This is a prayer that's focused on our responsibility. Amen. Praise God. There's a godless sign and a manless sign to every prayer for every marriage, every victim. Amen. That's the prayer. Prayer for me. I believe it's number 34, 35 somewhere. Prayer for me,
No one else is working with you. encourage people in the way that no one else can encourage. Even, I'm not going to even name this person's name that attends this church. And when she gets in trouble, she always calls me. And the Lord has just blessed me to get encouragement to her.
Yes.
Whatever I'm going to say, sister, this, I need you to pray with me. I'll drop whatever it is, you'll pray. And as a result, the Lord has really truly blessed them, Pastor, because they've gone through some situations. I'm not going to say who, because you'll know what it is, but God is just truly, and even another sister I've been encouraging, and he's letting me know that he has chosen me. I don't know what it is about the Lord has put me. He has put something in me to be able to encourage people.
Yes.
So I know that that is why God let me hear his speech to have a gift of encouragement. So I wanted to just thank him for that, because it just encourages me when I'm able to encourage someone else and not knowing, you know, what the outcome is going to be. But even with my own children, I'm able to, when they get in trouble, you know, I'm just honored that, you know, they pick up the phone and they call me.
Yes.
That's just my gift.
Thank you,
so
thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
So that's,
cannot encourage.
That's a good motivation for us to stay full of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Yes.
All right, praise God. All right, Brother Rob, do you have your book?
Which one, Pastor?
The one that.
Right
one. Oh, I have it.
Okay, do the one for the lost. What number is that?
Prayer calling for the forth the lost from the grips of Satan. Is that the one?
Yes, sir. The 36.
Okay, prayer for the lost. Oh, 36, I think.
The 36?
Yeah,
36. All right, Brother Rob. Okay, after you read it, you can pray. Yeah, I love my son today.
Yeah, let me use someone. Mine only goes up to 32.
Oh, you have the old one.
You'd be surprised having these people on it. Believe me, not even up to date.
Father, we know that is your, that it is your will that all men be saved and come into the knowledge of the truth.
Yes.
You are not slack or slow about what you promise, as some men's conception of slowness is. But you are long-suffering to upward, not willing that any should perish, but that all would come to repentance.
Yes.
Therefore, Father, we bring the lost of the world before you this day, those closest to our hearts, relatives, friends, neighbors, co-workers, etc. Also, those from here to the farthest corner of the earth, we bring before you. As we intercede, we use our faith, believing that thousands this day will have the opportunity to make Jesus their Lord. For everyone who has the opportunity, Satan, we bind your blinding spirit and influences over their lives and loose you from your assignment against those who have that opportunity to make Jesus their Lord.
Yeah.
Father, we pray that you give them the spirit of wisdom and revelation and the knowledge of you so that their spiritual eyes and understanding may be open so they can know the will of God for their lives. We ask you to send forth perfect laborers across their paths to share the good news of the gospel in a way that will bring conviction to their hearts and cause them to listen and understand. We believe that they will not be able to resist the wisdom, intelligence, and the anointing with which they shall speak. We confess that they shall see who have never been told of Jesus. They shall understand who have never heard of Jesus. And they shall come out of the snare of the devil who has held captive over them. They shall open their eyes and discern the truth and turn from darkness to light, from the power of Satan to you, God. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
We can follow that up just by saying, Father, we thank you. We thank you that your spirit rules and reigns.
Yes.
Father, we thank you that we have an opportunity to be here to be a blessing to you. And Lord, all that we encounter, Father, from this day forward, Father, we thank you that your spirit will reign in us and that they will see you through us.
Yes.
We thank you that for all those that are lost and do not know you yet, that they will. for every spirit that we have within us, Lord. We thank you for the ability to display that to others.
Yes.
Father, we thank you that your courage and your wisdom reigns through us. Your compassion, your understanding, it reigns through us, Lord. Father, we honor you today. We honor you with all our gifts. We honor you with all the things, for we were created to praise and to honor you. Today is the day that we will go forth and spread your word, spread your joy, spread your love, and spread your compassion. Father, we thank you for preparing the hearts and minds of everyone that we encounter. And we know that you are Lord, that you are God, that you are our Savior, Father. Thank you, Lord, that we have this opportunity today and always. And we praise you with all that we have and all that we are. And we thank you for blessing all of our families, all of those that are lost. They will come to know you. And we honor you, we praise you today, and we give you thanks. In Jesus' name, amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
All right,
Brother Ron, you prayed that song. I think a lot of us do this.
Yes.
Yes.
My confession unto manifestation.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord. What I confess, I will possess. What I say, I will have. What I decree shall be established. The mouth of the upright shall deliver them. I overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the words of my testimony.
Yeah.
The tongue of the wise brings help. My tongue makes me well. I have what I say.
Yeah.
I say that the Lord is my healer. He takes sickness away from me.
Yeah.
Bear my sickness and carry all my pain.
Yeah.
I say the word is life to them that find it.
Yeah.
And it's healing to all of my flesh. I say the word of God is full of life of God, and it is dispositing the life of God and the healing power of God into my spirit.
Yeah.
That life and health from the word is spreading out of my spirit into every tissue and pore of my body, creating health and soundness throughout my entire being. I say my body has no choice but to respond to the healing and the word that is being absorbed into me now. I speak health to every muscle, tissue, fiber, and cell in my body. I release God's healing power with the words into my whole body. The life of God is driving out every trace of and disease in my body now.
Yes.
The Lord is taking away from me all sickness. His word contains the ability to do what it says.
Yes.
The word, His word will not return void, but accomplish what is sent to do.
Yes.
Thank you, Father, for taking away from me all sickness, every trace of weakness and deficiency. Sickness is going out of me now. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has made me free from the law of sin and death. I claim my freedom now. I have been delivered from the power of darkness and have been transferred into the realm of God's dear Son, where I have healing and hope.
Yes.
In Jesus Christ, I have redemption. I have been ransomed from captivity and delivered from Satan and his works. The name of Jesus is greater than sickness. Jesus conquered sickness and disease. His name takes his place, and sickness has to submit to his name.
Yeah.
In the name of him who conquered sin, sickness, and Satan, I have commanded disease to leave my body. His name, through faith in his name, gives me health and perfect soundness. I am healed in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father, for my healing.
Yes.
I declare that no weapon formed against me shall prosper.
Yes.
And every lie that Satan speaks to my mind to deceive me is null and void.
Yes.
No spirit of infirmity that comes against me against my body will prevail.
Yes.
I believe that I have received my healing.
This
should be your continual confession until healing comes.
Yes.
Praise the name of the Lord.
I mean, praise God for that.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Money on the car for nothing?
Continue to have an amen that, hey, they still want this prayer to go on, not shut down. Yeah.
So I'm asking you, mighty God, you put in our spirit to have this prayer to keep going.
Yes.
Because I'm willing to keep going.
Yes.
It got to touch of me, so I don't want to stop, mighty God. Yeah. So I'm going to pray to you that you touch Pastor Hill home.
Yes.
And you don't let it stop. I'm asking you, mighty God, in your mighty name of Jesus,
yes,
keep this fire going, mighty God.
Yeah.
I know you want to keep going. And I know each one of us want to keep going.
Yeah.
So I'm asking you, mighty God.
Lord.
You keep this prayer going, mighty God.
Yeah.
You don't let it shut down, mighty God. Because we need it, mighty God.
Yes, Lord.
And it's very giving me a humble spirit now, mighty God.
Yes, Lord.
And I thank you, mighty God, for it. I thank you for it, mighty God.
Yes,
in your mighty name.
God.
In your mighty name.
Yes, Lord.
We all say amen.
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 Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Amen.